after we surveyed the situation and realized that it was an entire attached hive underneath this concrete structure, and Matt drove up with his truck and we looked at it and said, "Oh my gosh, you know what? We don't need to use a ladder, which is what we were going to do. Why don't we just drive the truck underneath and we can reach it?" So we, as we did that, we realized, look at the shape of that thing. It's kind of round. So we came up with the idea of let's take the 5 gallon bucket and push it over the entire hive. And then I had a Japanese pole saw that I used to actually cut in between the concrete and where the comb was all attached. And we just cut it off and it dropped into our bucket with some padding inside the bucket so it wouldn't, completely ruin it. And the whole thing came off in one fell swoop. All the bees were still up, inside the bucket, and then we slid a piece of cardboard over the top to keep the bees in the bucket. And then when we got it down on the ground, attached a mesh to cover it and keep the bees from flying out and give them lots of room to breathe, etc. We got home, Leo came over, and we took each piece of comb, shook the bees off into the bee box, and then reattached the comb pieces in onto empty frames with rubber bands. Apparently the bees will eventually reattach all the comb with wax because they do that, and then they'll also eat away the rubber bands, which is kind of interesting, and pull them out the front. So overall success, there was lots of brood in there, honey, pollen. It was quite something.